question from Rachna is, unless you're watching a video that we're actually going to compare very simple sugars, I don't have a lot of options we're going to talk about. We'll probably do a detailed, you know, sugar video some other time. So I have like 6 or 7 or whatever number of sugars that we're going to talk about, and talk about the best one maybe, or the better one. Let's see. So that's, you know, it's a flavored syrup. It's not pure sugar. A lot of people use it. And if you go to one of those your fancy coffee shops and you ask for, you know, something that's flavored with sugar, most probably they're going to add something like this. It's like a caramel flavored syrup. Don't get this. This is just full of high fructose corn syrup kind of stuff. So you want to stay away from any of these flavored syrups for any sweetening, okay? And then I have here, the next one I have here is agave. I know we've done a lot of my radio shows, we've talked about agave, but it's popular for a lot of people. I've done a lot of research, I've read a lot of books, Please don't use that. And the reason is why, of course, agave is a very high source of fructose. So the ratio of fructose and glucose is very high in agave. So it's not going to get the insulin up. That means the glycemic index is lower. But at the same time, it actually affects your liver directly because the liver cannot handle so much fructose all directly coming in. So not at all a good option. So please, if you're using agave, you know, don't. I would not. So that's not one of the best options. Okay. Then I have... in fact, you know, let's talk about dates. Dates, again, all natural, fantastic. Of course, you're high in glycemic index. Portion size, if you're eating just dates, maybe 2 or 3 dates is a portion size. If you end up eating about 5 or 6 dates, that's a little bit too much. But again, you can always use a sweetening. So if you're making any recipes, Indian recipes, non-Indian recipes, whatever recipes, desi recipes you're making, is perfectly fine to add dates. And dates are fantastic for adding sweetening to anything. So you can always, if you want a little bit more softer, you can always put them like a little bit warm water and let them soak, and then you can add it to anything, and that's going to sweeten up. Or either way, fantastic way to add natural sweetening to your things. Again, I personally try to get all organic dates, makes a big difference. Let's see, then we have that's honey. Again, honey is high in glycemic index, but of course it has a lot of, you know, a lot of good stuff, a lot of antibacterial properties, a lot of anti, you know, good stuff. What you want to make sure that you get some honey that's local. There's no reason to get honey that comes from 4 different states, because the best honey is always from the bees that are local in the area. So try to get like a local honey as opposed to getting one of the huge brand honeys. So this is a honey that comes from NorCal, so California. So it comes from, you know, Northern California. So it's a local honey. So try to get something. You can always go to farmer's market, but a lot of good stores would have always local honey. So get honey that's local. So again, good option. So again, all of these have sugars in them. Molasses is another fantastic way, especially low in iron. Molasses is a fantastic source to get your iron up. In fact, I've done a lot of research that show that if you could just take a tablespoon or maybe 2 tablespoons of molasses per day, you will never be iron deficient. You don't have to take any iron supplements. So that's how good molasses is. Again, it comes from cane sugar. It's an all different way of creating molasses, but again, it's fantastic. So what I probably try to get is always blackstrap molasses. So get something, it's like a thick liquid, even thicker than honey. So that's that. And then we have coconut sugar. One of my best options is coconut sugar. It kind of tastes like Indian gur or jaggery. It tastes amazing. So that's, you know, kind of looks like this. It's like brownish, you know, in color over here. Perfectly fine to use this. But again, it is all calories. All these things we've talked about so far are high, are calories, you know, because they're sugar. So again, it's a natural, or at least coming close to natural source, but it still has calories. If you're looking to cut calories, the best option you could probably go is stevia. So now I have 2 different types of stevias here. This is a stevia extract. Not my best option, because if I go back and look at the ingredients, there's, of course, there's stevia, but they have like 5 or 6 other things. I have sodium benzoate, that's a preservative, so I won't recommend sodium benzoate. And there's potassium sorbate. So it's like a liquid stevia extract that comes. I know you can get a lot of stevia extracts that are pure stevia, so if you get that, that's good. It's something that you won't really get in a lot of stores. When you get hands on it, order Amazon, whatever, perfectly fine. But the one I have here is a lot of, it's a stevia extract, it's liquid. Again, better, but again, not my best option. What I would possibly get is a pure organic stevia. You can also grow your own stevia, and this leaf, just one leaf of a stevia plant, is amazingly sweet if you are a person who likes to, you know, grow and stuff. But amazing option. But again, just get the stevia. Like I said, 0 glycemic index stevia. In fact, many researchers have shown that people who have diabetes, if you start taking stevia, their diabetes and insulin actually gets better. So you, in fact, I'm supposing maybe in the next some years we might even have stevia as a cure for diabetes. So it's that's how amazing stevia is. So try to get to stevia if you really want to cut your calories, have something that's low in glycemic index. It takes a little while, I would say maybe 2 weeks. But what happens, a lot of people give up in the first 2 weeks. And I always say, you know, you have to give something a try at least for 2 weeks to 20 days to make a habit, because we're so used to having all different sweeteners. So of course it tastes different because it's different. So give it 2 weeks. Trust me, you'll get so used, you won't even know what regular sugar would taste like. That. So maybe 3 weeks for, you know, based on person to person. But again, 3 weeks, you'll all be perfectly fine. You would not even want to have regular sugar. It just tastes, that's how fine it tastes. So so again, thumbs up to stevia. So that's my show. If you like my video, give a thumbs up. Again, subscribe to Rachna as well. We'll see you again in the next video.